Welcome to Port Talk. This is the show where we highlight one outstanding member of Commander Fleet Activities Yokosuka.
On today's episode, I'm going to be talking with Master at Arms Second Class Amber Ortiz from the Military Working Dog section.
Before we begin, could you say a few words why you have chosen to highlight MA2 Ortiz?
Definitely. MA2 Ortiz, since day one of my arrival here at CFAY's Kennel Master, has been nothing but a stellar performer. She's always on time, does everything the correct way, and she trains dogs and she takes everything, you know, very prideful in this job. We all have to, but she's definitely went above and beyond, and I just wanted to showcase her, not only skills, but just her as a dog trainer and being able to train multiple kennels so we can greater enhance the military working dog program all throughout Japan's AOR.
Obviously, the goal is to go through the warehouse and have the dog find all the aids. Basically, when I come in for most training problems, there's different things that we can be working on. You can be working on deeper plants with your dog, so getting them to find it when it's maybe 4 or 5 feet deep in a pile or higher. There's all different things that you can work on. For today, just working on kind of watching my dog, holding him accountable, making sure he's hitting all his corners and everything, and then I'm doing my part. Adam's a really, really great dog. He works very well independently, so he doesn't need a lot of help from me, but basically every time I go into a training problem, my biggest goal is just to do my part and help him be successful. So.
Awesome. So how different is it training a working dog compared to training a dog at home?
Honestly, I would say it's not really all that different. The principles are essentially going to be the same. Whether you're training a working dog, your own, you know, pet, if you were trying to train a goat, I mean anything, you're gonna use the same essential principles. I think the only difference would be for the person. Obviously with military working dogs, we have stricter standards because we expect more from them and we do need them to do a job and to listen to us in high stress moments and things like that. So they train harder.
Could you tell us a little bit about where you grew up?
Sure. I grew up in Racine, Wisconsin. It's kind of a rural industrial town. It's just outside of the city of Milwaukee.
What made you want to join the Navy?
I decided to join the Navy because I was just finishing up an associate's degree in criminal justice. I was interested in a career in law enforcement, and as I said, there's not a lot to do in my hometown, so I was kind of feeling just bored and kind of stuck. I wanted to travel, I wanted to challenge myself to different things career-wise. So the Navy seemed like a good opportunity to do something that I had never really considered before, and also to get out and have those travel opportunities and life experiences that I felt like I would have missed out on back home.
So what do you like to do for fun?
This is gonna sound probably pretty cheesy, but I actually really like to be at work. I love my job, I'm passionate about it. After work, the gym, you can find me either at work, at the gym, or eating food.
So what are some of your goals while stationed here?
When it comes to my career, I definitely want to deploy and be able to support, you know, our mission and support my country in that way. And also just being in Japan, this country has a lot to offer when it comes to experiences and food. So I definitely want to make sure that I get out and see the sights and visit the nearby countries and kind of take advantage of the proximity.
Where have you visited so far outside of the base?
So outside of Yokosuka, I've been up to Hokkaido. I've been down to Osaka, Kyoto area. I went to Singapore, and I've got Bali and some other places on my list. So
what has been your favorite thing to do so far being in Japan?
My favorite thing that I have done in Japan so far is actually take a trip up to Hokkaido with my sister. Our grandfather was stationed up there during World War II as a paratrooper for the Army. So she came out and visited this winter. We took a nice little trip up there, did some sightseeing in some of the places where he was, and checked out Sapporo. And so that was obviously very special for us, to be somewhere that he was during a time that was very significant in his life.
What is your favorite thing about being a military working dog handler?
There's a lot of things I love about it. I guess my favorite would be that every day is like a totally different day. We could be killing it at one thing today and I come in tomorrow and we have a whole new challenge to work on with something else. There's so many different aspects. Dogs are living creatures, so they're constantly changing. They're not really ever the same. No two dogs are the same. So it just kind of keeps you on your toes when it comes to thinking about new training techniques, how to implement, different training techniques, what works for you, what works for your dog, what works for you two as a team. It's always interesting. You never know what to expect when you come in every day, so.
What do you hate most about the job? I'm just kidding. So overall, how has your experience been stationed here so far?
I love it. It's been a wonderful experience. It definitely helps that we have a really great kennel here. All of the handlers, helped take care of me when I got here, got me checked in, gave me tips on how to find housing and getting a car and everything else. So having a support system when I came in definitely helped, but overall it's been really wonderful.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe if you want to see any future episodes. See you later.